Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm back with an art journal. I will be working on my Moleskine sketchbook, and today's inspiration came from this stamp. This is a stamp by Stampendous, which I really loved the moment I saw it. So I decided to make a rainy day background for my rainy boots. To start with, I want to create a kind of a cloud at the top, so I'm going to use some masking tape and I'm going to use this die to cut out a couple of masks so that I can protect the top of my pages. If you don't have such a die, you can always use your pencil, draw a cloud shape and just cut it out by using your scissors on a masking tape. So this is self-adhesive. But it is very low tack, so it's going to be super easy to remove. I'm going to protect the top of my pages, and now I can go ahead and add my paint. Now for today's art journal, I'm not going to prepare my surface with gesso. I find that I don't really need to do that when I'm working with my distress paints. So I'm going to apply my first layer, and you can see that I have three different colors from lighter to darker, and you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, including the names of all the colors that I'm using. Now I'm going to switch to the second color, and again with my brayer I'm going to apply the second color on top. Now notice how I am not trying to cover up the whole surface. I just like to have all those imperfections which are going to give a great texture on my page. Now for the center, where the spine is, I'm going to use a baby wipe and apply a little bit of paint directly there. Now my baby wipe is almost dry. I had this on my table for a while, so it's not just moving the paint around or wiping it out, which makes it easy for me to use it as a dabber. And now I will use a darker color, which is going to make a big difference. Now you can see that I am using the old type of distress paint with the dabbers on top, but you can find them with flip tops, which are even better for this technique where you want to apply a little bit of paint on your craft mat to grab it with your brayer. So I'm mixing both colors, the middle color and the darker color, on my craft mat. And then I go with my brayer on my pages until I'm happy. You can go darker, you can add lighter tones, it's up to you. Now with my baby wipe, I'm going to make sure that I have enough paint just where that masking tape is. And I'm going to do some stamping to add even more texture and interest on my background. So I'm using this dot stamp with some archival ink, and just because I think that this archival ink was quite dark, I am doing a second generation stamping. So first I am stamping on a scrap paper and then I go directly on my page. Archival ink is permanent, which means that when this is going to dry, it's going to be permanent and it's not going to smudge or smear whatever I do on top. Now again I'm going to use this script stamp, and I am going to add even more texture at the background with the same archival ink. I am stamping in different areas. I'm not going for a perfect impression. I just want to have that text here and there. And now finally I'm going to use this stencil. This is a paper stencil by Faber-Castell, and what I love about those stencils is that they come in a pack with many different designs, and you really don't have to clean it just because it's made out of cardstock. You can go over it with your paints, your dabbers, or your modeling paste, and then you just wipe it off and you are good to go. So with my dabber, and this is the lighter color that I used for my background, I'm going over it in different areas. Now I'm going to do the exact same thing with the darker color that I used on my background. Notice that I don't introduce a different color, and that's because I want to keep my background subtle, so I'm just working with the three colors that I used on the background. At this stage I'm quite happy with how my background looks. I'm going to remove the masking tape And I always find it so satisfying when I am removing the masking tape. I don't know why. So anyway, this is how my background is looking at the moment. And here is a close-up to see all the texture. Now I'm going to apply some matte medium all over the place. And that's because I know that I will be using my big brush markers later on to do the shading. And big brush markers only work on non-porous surfaces. So I'm just going to cover up everything. I don't apply too much. I just add a light layer there. And I'm going to make sure that everything is dry before I go ahead and do my next step. A lot of people ask me about how I care for the brushes that I use for matte medium. I just drop them in a jar of water until I finish my art journal, and when I finish my project, I go to the sink and wash them with warm water and a little bit of soap. As long as you don't let the matte medium dry on your brush, you are good to go. I have those brushes for ages and they are always nice and soft. Now, just because I love splashes, I am using this thin brush with gesso, which is diluted with water. And I'm adding some splashes on the background. I always like to add white splashes at the background, just because I use a lot my gel pen to create highlights on my page. And this helps everything bind together. So now I'm going to go all over the outside edge with a big brush marker. And this, I believe, is ultramarine, and I'm adding a little bit of shading. Now, this is very, very easy to do, to smudge with your finger, just because I have used matte medium, which is now dry. Remember, you need to make sure that matte medium is totally dry before you touch it with your big brush markers. Otherwise, it acts like a glue. It's going to stick on top of your tip of the marker, and it's going to ruin it. If you take a good care of your supplies, you will have them for years. I had these markers for years and years, they never dried on me, and their tips are in perfect condition. Now I am working on my clouds. I want to make them look more dimensional, and at the same time I want to get rid of that white space there, just because these are rain clouds, they should be grey. And here is a closer look to the clouds. And now I'm going to work on my focal points. So I'm going to use this mixed media paper by Ranger. And I'm going to do some stamping here of my focal points. So first I'm going to stamp those boots by Stampendous. And I'm going to use black archival ink, just because it is permanent. And no matter what I do on top, it's not going to smear. And here is where I decided that I want to embellish my boots a little bit more. So I grabbed another stamp set by Stampendous, which is called Happy Bird. And I am going to stamp some flowers from there. Now, I always like to stamp my focal points on a different piece of paper and then stick it on top of my pages, because this gives me the ability to help my focal points stand even more against the background. I have cut out all my little elements, and I'm now going to decide where everything is going to go, and then stick everything down with matte medium. As I'm going to stick them down, I'm going to make sure that I cover up all the images with gel medium as well, so that I can use my big brush markers later on to color and shade them. Now I need to draw the stems for all those flowers as if they are coming out of the boots. I am going to use this fresh lime by Dilutions with a very thin brush. And as you can see, it is quite opaque, so it is going to block the blue from the background. If I was going to draw that with my big brush markers, it wouldn't work just because big brush markers are transparent. Which is of course handy when it comes to coloring all those images, so I will be using my big brush markers to color the images and to do the shading, but just because they are transparent, they will not fade out all those black lines of my designs. So I'm going to put on some music as I am coloring my images here, and I will catch you back once everything is ready. At this stage, I am going to use my thin black marker and I'm going to draw black lines for the stems, and that's just because I want to be consistent. All my images have black lines around them, so I need to do that for the stems as well. And I'm also going to do that for the bottom of the clouds. And if you notice, this dark line just underneath those clouds give them even more shading and they pop even more against that blue background. So now I'm going to continue coloring my flowers. Again, I'm using the same technique. And at the bottom of my page there, I want to create a puddle, so as if my boots are standing inside that puddle of water. So I am drawing with my thin black marker just a shape of that. I'm just going to add a little bit of blue, which is a different color than the background. It is going to give just a little bit of definition. And this is where I decided that I need to add a little bit of shading underneath my boots. I am just touching the tip of a brown marker underneath those boots to add just a touch of shade there. I am going to make sure that this is dry so it turns permanent, and then on top I'm going to use my blue marker again. I am going to move on to the next step, which is using my white gel pen, and I'm going to add my favorite highlights. I always like to do that on my pages. And I am going to add highlights on everything, pretty much everything, the flowers, the stems, the leaves, the boots, even the paddle. Now, for my quote, I'm going to use this Tampentu stamp that says, "When life gives you a rainy day, wear cute boots and dance in the puddles." And just because I want the phrase "rainy day" to stand out against the rest of the quote, I decided to stamp those two words with another alphabet, so I am changing the font into a bigger one. And I'm going to stamp "rainy day" with black ink and then stamp the rest of the quote at the top and at the bottom of that phrase. And remember that we are stamping on top of a bulky book, so in case you don't get a perfect impression, it's okay. You can always go back with a thin black marker and fix any mistakes. So now, since I want to do some partial stamping of this quote, I am adding the ink exactly where I want it to go by using my big brass marker. And again, if you don't stamp something perfectly, you can always use your thin black marker and go over the quote to make it look even bolder, which is exactly what I am going to do here. And once I finished stamping my quote, top and bottom, I am using my white gel pen to add some highlights at the phrase that says "rainy day," which is going to help it stand even more against the background. And now it's time to add the rain. For that I'm going to use my Nuvo Drops, and this is Glitter Nuvo Drops. So I am going to add some dots here and there, and you will see that I'm using two different colors, just to add more interest on my page. And now with the pin, I'm going to drag that dot towards the top. So I am creating the perfect raindrop. I like finishing touches on my pages, and just because I have so much fun when I am creating an art journal page, I just don't know when to stop. So anyway, I'm going to add many of those raindrops, and I'm mainly staying at the top of my page. And now I'm going to introduce the second color, which is a darker one. Again, I am adding my drops, my dots, and then with my pin, I'm going to make them all into raindrops. So I have finished with the raindrops, and now very carefully, without touching the tip of my gel pen onto those glitter drops, just because they are not dry yet, I am going to create some stitched lines as if they are hanging from the clouds. I think this is giving a very whimsical touch to my page. And also, this is what you do when you don't know when to stop and you can't just leave that page alone. And all that's left to do now is to stamp the date. So that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of today's project. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos that I have created a while back. Thank you all for watching.